All right, so hopefully you have a better understanding of why OnClick Listener is an interface with an abstract method called OnClick. Your role as the developer is to set up the event listeners for the input events you want to handle in your app. More specifically, for each listener, you will need to follow three steps. Number one, define the event listener and the custom behavior for when the event happens. Number two, create a new object instance of the event listener by calling the constructor. And number three, attach the listener to the view you want to listen for events on. And I'll show you the code you need at each step. First, we need to define an event listener class that implements the interface. You can call it anything you want, as long as it follows the Java conventions for naming classes. In this case, we named the class numbersClickListener, and this code is located in a new file called numbersClickListener.java. When we define the numbersClickListener class, the declaration should say public class, followed by the name of the class, followed by the word implements, and then the interface name, which is onClickListener in this case. So note that implements is a Java keyword that has a special meaning, and you can find a list of these special keywords in the Java Oracle documentation here. We use implements to express that the numbersClickListener class will support the specified interface and provide code for all its abstract methods. By implementing the onClickListener interface, for every piece in the Android code that expects an onClickListener object type, we can use the numbersClickListener. And right before the method, we have this @override annotation. This means that we are overriding the blank method in the interface and providing our own implementation. Our implementation of the onClick method is that we want a toast message to pop up that says, open the list of numbers. We could have provided any other custom behavior here. This was just an example. Once we define our numbersClickListener class, we need to create an object instance of it. If you remember from the last course, we have the class template, but we need to create object instances of it. We just created the floor plan, but we need an actual house. Remember back to the syntax for creating an object using a constructor. To create a numbersClickListener object instance, we can call the constructor for the class with the new keyword. This creates a new object that we can store in this variable on the left-hand side, where the variable is of this data type. Within the Miwok app, this is what the code looks like in the main activity file. We modify the main activity so that we can immediately start listening for click events as soon as the activity is created. We're creating a new numbersClickListener object and storing it in a variable called clickListener, which is of the variable data type numbersClickListener. So once we have an object instance of the numbersClickListener, we need to attach it to the view that we want to listen for clicks on. And this is the code for that. Assuming we have the view stored as a variable called buttonView, we just need to call the setOnClickListener method on that view and pass in one parameter argument, the clickListener variable. Well, how do we know to call this method with this particular input argument? Back to our handy dandy documentation. Here we'll take a look at the view class, and it has a method called setOnClickListener, where you pass in an onClickListener. Since the numbersClickListener implements this interface, it is also considered an onClickListener data type, and we can pass that in as an input to the method. Now let's see what the code looks like within the context of the app. However, you won't need to make these changes just yet. The quiz in the next video will give you more specific instructions on what we need to do. So just follow along and try to understand the logic. So here I've created a numbersClickListener class and defined it in its own Java file. Remember that we specify the package name in the code so that our code is bundled under this unique package name. Then we have the import statements because we're using the Vue and Toast classes, and we can use them even though we didn't create them ourselves because we're importing them. Then in the class declaration, we have implements Vue.onClickListener. And I'd like to point out that we add Vue.onClickListener to be very explicit that we're referring to the onClickListener that is part of the Vue.java file in this package. And recall that we use the dot operator to access Java class members. So here in the numbersClickListener, I've created an onClick method. And in it, I've said that when the numbers category is clicked on, we choose to display a toast message that says, open the list of numbers. And there you have it. This is the numbersClickListener. Now I'm going to switch over to the main activity. And at the end of the onCreate method, we need to create a new clickListener object. Now we need to attach the clickListener to the numbers category view. However, first we need to find that view object in the Vue hierarchy. And this process should be familiar to you from the Just Java app in the last course. So here's how we're going to write that code. So to find the view that shows the number category, so here I call the findViewById method and request the view with the ID numbers. So once we find the text view, we can store it in a variable that I'm going to call numbers. Then we can call the setOnClickListener method on this text view and pass the ClickListener object as the input. So here's how that would look. So here we set the setOnClickListener method on the text view and pass in the ClickListener object as its input. So the text view numbers in our case will store the ClickListener object. And later, if this text view is pressed, the ClickListener jumps into action. In order to test that this Java code I wrote actually works, I have to delete some old code that we wrote for the button click. So in the activity_main.xml file, I'll need to delete the Android onClick attribute on the numbers text view. So in the main activity, I also need to remove the openNumbersList method. And this leaves the main activity with one method, the onCreate method. Now when I run the app on my device, clicking the numbers category pops up a toast message. Great. Now my ClickListener code is working.